Hi friends, today we are going to see how an LTI system responds to a given input signal. So let us consider a system as y of n equals to 0.2 x of n minus 0.5 x of n minus 1 plus 0.4 x of n minus 3. So let us consider that this is the given system wherein I have the output. This is my output, which we called as present output. It depends on present input. This is present input. This is past input. And this is also past input. Okay. So we have the output depends on the inputs alone. Also, it has been mentioned that the output of a system should be found or to be determined for the input sequence, which is given as minus 1, 1, 0, and minus 1. So this is the input signal that we have been given, and I wanted to determine the output sequence of this given system. So first I need to understand that what my system looks like. To do that, so let us go with the solution. So the problem was to determine the output of a given system for a particular input. So this is my input. So the solution says that step 1, apply Z transform to the equation number 1. So when I apply Z transform to equation 1, I replace all yn's with yz and xn with xz's. So I get yz 0.2 xz minus 0.5 scaling factor z raised to minus 1 xz plus 0.4 z raised to minus 3 xz. Therefore, y of z by x of z will be equal to 0.2 minus 0.5 z inverse plus 0.4 z raised to minus 3, which is nothing but h of z. So the h of z of this system is, h of z of the system is 0.2 minus 0.5 z inverse plus 0.4 z raised to minus 3. This is my transfer function. Now, we consider that h of z, that is a system transfer function, is equal to output upon input, right? So we have the transfer function, which is a ratio of output upon input. So now they have asked me to find an output for a particular input. So if I know the transfer function and the input, I can give the output by just multiplying the input on the other side. So my output will be equal to my transfer function into my input, right? Now, the same thing if I write mathematically, it will be y of z will be equal to h of z into x of z. This x of z is my new input. This is my input new, for which I wanted to give them the output. Okay. So now, the transfer function that I got for the system is 0.2 minus 0.5 z inverse plus 0.4 z raised to minus 3. I need to just multiply this with x of z to give me y of z. So the next question is, what is x of z? So from the given sequence, I can calculate x of z easily. So from the given sequence, x of z can come as x of n is given as minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1. This is the given input sequence. So I apply z transform to obtain x of z. So directly applying, let us consider this to be n is equal to 0 because it is not mentioned that where is the origin. So by default, the origin is the first place. Now x of z will be equal to, for origin that n is equal to 0, z raised to 0, I get here minus 1, okay, plus 1, z raised to minus 1, plus 0, z raised to minus 2, plus minus 1 into z raised to minus 3. Rewriting this equation, minus 1 plus z inverse, this will go to 0, and this will come as minus z raised to minus 3, right? So this is by applying the z transform. Just to recall, a recall statement, x of z is equal to summation n going from 0 to, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, x of n z raised to minus n. So I will go on putting the values of n and evaluating this summation, that will give me this answer. Now we have x of z and we have h of z. Now just to obtain the y of z, we need to multiply them both. So this is 0.2 minus 0.5 z inverse plus 0.4 z raised to minus 3 into 1 plus z raised to minus 1 minus z raised to minus 3. So that comes to, now let us multiply. You get, when you multiply with 1, you get 0.2 plus 0.2 z inverse minus 0.2 z raised to minus 3 minus 0.5 z raised to minus 1 minus 0.5 z raised to minus 2 minus 0.5 z raised to minus 4, because 3 multiplied by minus 1 will give me minus 4. Then I will multiply the whole stuff again by 0.4, it will be plus 0.4 z raised to minus 3, then plus 0.4 z raised to minus 4, and this will come as minus 0.4 z raised to minus 6. Okay, now let us add up the coefficients with common degrees of z. So we have 0.2 with no common degree of z, that will come as it is. Then we have z inverses. So just count the number of z inverses. So the z inverses over here are, so let us count z inverses. So z inverses in this case is 1, 2, there are 2 z inverses. So this combination, that is minus 0.5 plus 0.2, will give me 0.3 z inverse. So I get 0.3 z inverse. Then count z raised to minus 2, there is only 1 z raised to minus 2, which is minus 0.5. Count z raised to minus 3, this one is, let me use another color. So we have z raised to minus 3 over here and z raised to minus 3 over here. It is 0.4 minus 0.2 will give me 0.2 z raised to minus 3. Then now z raised to minus 4 is this term, and z raised to minus 4 is this term also. So that will give me minus 0.1 z raised to minus 4. So now we got the required polynomial. So I'll write the polynomial in proper fashion. We got 0.2 plus 0.2 z raised to 0.3 z raised to minus 1. Then we have a minus 0.5 z raised to minus 2. Then we have a plus 0.2 z raised to minus 3. Then lastly we have a minus 0.1 z raised to minus 4, and finally we have minus 0.4 z raised to minus 6. We do not require y of z, but we want y of n, that is the output of a system. So to achieve y of n from y of z, the last step, that is to apply inverse z transform. If I apply inverse z transform, then I will get back my y of n. So to apply inverse z transform, y of z will get converted to y of n. Now here there is z raised to 0, plus or minus does not matter. So whenever you write this, you have to write the first the coefficient values you have to write when you have all in terms of z inverses. So 0.2 then you have 0.3, then you have minus 0.5, then we have 0.2, then we have minus 0.1, and we don't have anything for z raised to minus 5 over here. So you cannot just write 0.4 minus over here, because this is a place for n is equal to 5. So for n is equal to 5, you have to put a 0, and then you will put minus 0.4. So this is my n is equal to 5 place. This is my n is equal to 0 place. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So the degree of the z actually tells you the place at which the coefficient need to be placed. If suppose we had positive powers of z, then they will come below or before n is equal to 0 position. So probably if suppose I have y of z as somewhere around like z raised to 2 plus 0.5 z raised to plus 1 plus 0.2 z plus 0.3 z raised to minus 1. In such kind of cases where the positive powers of z's are also there, you have to write y of n as y of n equals to the first position. You have to write the highest degree of the positive, the highest positive degree of z should be written first. Here it is 2, so its coefficient is 1, so I'll write 1 over here. Then the next power is 0.5, that I'll write over here. Then the next is, there is no 0.2 kind of a thing, that is there is no z raised to 0 point. So when there is no z raised to 0, I cannot skip. I need to put a 0 because it is 0 z raised to 0. Then I have 0.2 and then I have 0.3. So this will start the highest degree of positive power of z, and this will end with the highest degree of negative power of z. And wherever you don't find any coefficient in between, then you have to put zeros. That will give you the output of a system. Thank you.